Joe, it's been too long. You know what? Keep up the good fight. You've got hundreds and hundreds of thousands of people who believe that you have a right to ask a question for which there's not been a satisfactory answer. I consider you a friend, and I hope you consider me a friend as well.
Dude, this is the time you find out who your friends are, and I appreciate it, Michael.
Joe Farah, God bless you. Thanks for being on the Savage Nation. The time is 49 minutes after the hour. You're listening to the one and only Savage Nation. If you want to talk about the controversy emanating from Cambridge, Massachusetts, of Henry Louis Gates Jr., the renowned African-American scholar, and the poor white trash cop, give me a call at 1-800-449-8255.
No one else can say it that clear and that precise. And he has passion, of course.
The Savage Nation. Weekday afternoons 3 to 7. Talk 910 KNEW.
You know when. You know I love you. Yes, I do. And I'm keeping on my.
So the police are saying to Obama, you apologize. Obama's saying he's not. They're both wrong. Truthfully, at this point, the Solomon-esque reality is that Gates was an ass. The cop was wrong. He overreacted at the end of the day. Because although Gates was an ass and insulted him, that's not a reason to arrest him. That's the absolute truth. I mean, the truth is, at the end of the day, I don't like Gates' false scholarship. But looking at it from the outside, Gates was wrong to curse the cop, do the mama number, and the cop overreacted, got pissed off, and handcuffed him and arrested him. So where do we go from here? Now, you know, you got to go back to the beginning here. They handcuff Harvard race professor Henry Louis Gates Jr. Obama's plunged into a national race controversy. But who actually triggered this is the question. It's a neighbor and a university colleague named Lucia Whalen, who calls the police to report two African-American men wearing backpacks attempting to break into Gates' house. Now, Whalen, the woman, works as a circulation and fundraising manager at the Harvard University magazine. Strangely, the publication's offices are located only a few doors from Gates' home. So why did she not recognize Gates when he was trying to get into his own home? I mean, that's the real question here. Maybe she should be arrested for racism. New York City, line 7, go ahead, please.
Yes, I'm a relatively new listener, and I know you have a tendency of talking over people or insulting people when...
Well, that's what you're doing right now. You're trying to set me up so I can't say a word to you, thinking you're going to play that game with me, but it's not going to work. So the thing to do here is just make your case, please.
...with you regarding the Dr. Gates, Professor Gates, because after it was established that he was in his own home and he was not a burglar, he was not a thief, he was not an intruder, what reason did the cops have to arrest him? That was wrong.
Well, that is a good question, but what reason did Gates have to say, I'll talk to your mama outside? Do you think that that was professorial?
No, exactly what went on in that home when...
No, you didn't answer me, though. Let's agree that the cop overreacted. Would you say that Professor Gates acted in a distinctly professorial manner?
Okay, hold on, but what...
You hold on. You won't answer a question. I asked you a question. I gave you a point, but you're not listening to a word I say because you're coming into this with your own biases. I'm asking a simple question. Do you think saying to a cop, I'll talk to your mama outside, do you think that's the appropriate response for a professor?
That wasn't the appropriate response. Okay. But
all right, so we can agree that both of them acted like asses, yes?
I agree. If that was the case, then both of them were wrong. But what reason...
All right, so we agree. So what's the point of getting mad at each other?
But what was the point of the cops entering his home? He was in his own home, and after it was established that he was not an intruder, he should have left. And, you know, and it's all to do about nothing. We should be talking about these crooks in New Jersey and all of these...
That is correct. We should be talking about the crooks in the White House. We should be talking about the crooks in the White House trying to force socialized medicine down our throats at the cost of trillions of dollars. I agree with you. It's a distraction from the actual gangsters who are running the country. You're 100% right, lady. Thanks for the call. I'm glad you're a new listener. I'll be right back. Savage.
Michael Savage.
Afternoons 3 to 7
on Talk 910 KNEW
and online at 910KNEW.com.
1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're going to rock around the clock tonight. But it's a bad, bad song.
The Savage Nation. I'm not going to get excited over old rock and roll. I'll play it anyway. Maybe someone likes it. Generate excitement over this. Got a country melting down with a con man as president. Gangsters running the Democrat Party off the cliff. And I'm supposed to worry about some loudmouth professor in Harvard and a thin-skinned cop. Did I say it like it is? A loudmouth professor and a thin-skinned cop. Boston Globe scrubs Henry Louis Gates' arrest report from website. Well, that's because it was shown to be what he is. A loudmouth. They redacted it. They've redacted almost the entire narrative section of the original police report, too. So, as I learned when I was 15, if you get stopped by a police officer for a possible traffic violation, you get, what you do is you're polite. Very polite. Even if you're wrongly stopped, you don't start yelling at the cop. You don't call him cracker. You don't say, when he says, please step outside of the car, you don't say, I'll step out and talk to your mama. Otherwise, you're liable to wind up tasered. But I guess Henry Louis Gates Jr. doesn't understand that because he's special. He's a classic special case. Not only is a distinguished professor who deserves to be invited to the White House and run an entire division. He should have. I think that they should create a new Department of Race Relations in the White House that costs $1 trillion a year. Because we all need to have a furtherance of this dialogue. We need to have a further conference and a dialogue about this. And there's no one better to talk about it than this distinguished professor from Harvard who knows more about race than God himself. So can we end it now? Obama says he's a friend and he doesn't even know all the facts, and he made a mistake. All right, then, and next he says he acted. He himself made a mistake. He admitted it. Give him credit for that. At least he realizes that the training wheels that he's been riding around on showed. We all know that he's not a legitimate president in that regard. We know he's a faker. We also know he's a president in training. He's about 10 years too soon to have even been a president, but all right, that's what we're stuck with. We have what we have here. It's a president on training wheels. And apparently, when they took away the teleprompter, you saw the training, the president of training, the PIT. So what would you like to talk about? We could also talk about the case in New Jersey with the rabbis. I did it yesterday. I mean, you think I'm unfair here. I was merciless toward the rabbis. Merciless. You should have heard the show yesterday. Mercilessly ripped them apart. I said there should be a special place in hell for rabbis like this. Anyone who cloaks himself in religion and uses it to con money is a double bang. I mean, assuming that you believe there's a judgment day, this guy goes to the lower rung, let's say. It's not the worst crime you can commit. He's only doing what the government does, but we're going to find out, sorry, in this hour on the Savage Nation, from a reporter from New Jersey, Paul Mulshine from the Star-Ledger, which charities the rabbis were allegedly funneling money through. I want to hear the names of the charities. Sacramento Bill, welcome to the Savage Nation. Topic, please.
Hey, I'm a black man. I live in Lodi, California, and I did something similar to what happened to Gates here a few months ago. I come home, I accidentally put in my duress code on my alarm. I was in the house about 3 or 4 minutes, and a knocking on my garage door, I went and answered it, and there was two police officers pointing guns at me. They wanted to know who I was and if I lived there. I showed them my ID. They then proceeded to check every room and closet in my house to make sure I wasn't just trying to get rid of them because someone was being held.
Oh, so it's police procedure that even if they knew it was Gates, they didn't know if Gates had been, in other words, forced to say go away, in other words.
They reported two men there. Where was the other guy? He could have been held and his wife in the back room just trying to get
rid of them. Oh, my God, I didn't even see that. Honest to God, I didn't understand that, Bill.
Their promptness, I appreciated their thoroughness, and I did not get pissed off because I was a black man in America. I am so tired of these, my family's full of it, and I'm just tired of these people blaming white men for everything. They need to get off their butts and go out and do something about their image and stop ruining it for the rest of us.
Wow. Well, Bill, I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say other than you enlighten me on police procedure. In other words, the woman asked in the last hour, why did the policeman, once she saw the ID, not go away? Now you explain why.
What prompted my call?
Thank you very much. I appreciate it. We won't censor your call.
Whew.
Mark in Connecticut, you're up on the Savage Nation.
Michael, thanks for taking my call. I just want to put W.E.B. Du Bois in context, please. He earned an advanced degree at a time when African Americans were getting lynched. And the only way I can say it is, if you were to earn an advanced degree during the Holocaust, I really wouldn't hold it against you if you were not a good German. You know what I'm saying?
I'm sorry, I can't follow the logic, but I think it makes sense to you.
What was said was, W.E.B.
Du Bois, there's in the W.E.B. Du Bois Institute for African-American Research at Harvard, and Gates teaches there, correct?
It was said that the scholar